How is it going, everybody? Mr. Android here. Welcome back to a brand new video on this channel. Here I have two of the most popular smartphones of 2023. I have the Galaxy S23 Ultra, which is probably the best Android phone that has launched this year. And I also got the iPhone 15 Pro Max, which is the latest and greatest from Apple. Even though this is the best iPhone that you can get right now, I'll show you 10 reasons why the S23 Ultra is still better and more superior compared to the iPhone 15 Pro Max. So stay tuned and watch this video till the very end. Also, let's aim for at least 1000 likes on this one. With that said, drop a like, leave a comment, and let's get started. The first and the very basic feature that is still missing in iPhone is the fingerprint scanner. When using the iPhone 15 Pro Max, there were times when I was not in a position to unlock this phone with Face ID, but there is no other option, and the only way to unlock this device is by entering your password or PIN. It gets really annoying when you have to lift your phone and show your face every time just to unlock it. On the other hand, the S23 Ultra not only supports Face ID, but it also lets you to unlock your phone using the ultrasonic fingerprint scanner. It works extremely well without any issue. You just need to tap and it unlocks instantly. Now, since we are talking about Samsung, did you know you can assign more actions to the fingerprint scanner? So not only you can use your finger to unlock your phone, but you can even register the other finger to launch any of your favorite app. I usually use my right thumb to unlock the phone, and when I use my left thumb, not only it unlocks, but it instantly opens up my favorite application. This definitely gives me more flexibility, and it's always good to have more options. Next, if you talk about displays, I absolutely love the display on both of these phones. They are super high quality and you even get a brighter panel on the iPhone 15 Pro Max. However, when you start watching movies or any content on these phones, the S23 Ultra somehow feels more immersive thanks to its boxy design and a small punch hole when compared to the huge pill-shaped notch that is still present on the iPhone 15 Pro Max. This basically causes a display intrusion, especially when you're watching movies or any videos on your phone. Another thing that I didn't like about the 15 Pro Max is despite having such a beautiful display, Apple doesn't provide any feature to improve your multitasking experience. On my S23 Ultra, I can simply swipe with my two fingers and it allows me to use two apps at the same time. And I can also run multiple apps in a pop-up window like this. Guys, these kind of features enhances your smartphone experience, and since you have got a device with such beautiful display, you need features that can help you to get full advantage of that bigger screen. Now let's talk about a brand new feature that came to the iPhone 15 Pro, and that is the action button. So instead of the mute switch, we now have an action button that can be used to assign different actions on your phone. This is definitely more useful than just having a mute switch. But did you know, we already have a more powerful and superior action button present on our Samsung devices that can take multiple actions. So unlike the 15 Pro Max, where you can assign only one task to the action button, let's say you have set it to flashlight, you can only use it to toggle the flashlight and nothing else. On the S23 Ultra, I can do multiple actions using the same power button. As you can see, when I single press, it locks my phone. Double pressing the same button will launch the camera. And if I long press, it toggles the flashlight. Like this, you can configure and assign different actions to this power button. I think it is definitely more superior compared to the brand new action button that we have on the 15 Pro Max. Next, if we talk about cameras, there is 48 megapixels on the 15 Pro Max versus 200 megapixels on the S23 Ultra. Honestly, I do notice slightly more details when taking pictures on the Samsung phone, but for an average person, what's more important is the zoom capacity that you get on the S23 Ultra. The fact you have got 3x and a 10x telephoto lens. Not only that, there is also space zoom, which is a form of digital zoom that can reach 30x or even 100x if you need it. This is definitely one of the most powerful camera hardware you can get on any smartphone. And even though Apple added a 5x telephoto lens on the 15 Pro Max, I don't think it is anywhere close to what Samsung offers in the camera department. Next, I would like to talk about the amount of customization Samsung offers. No matter which Samsung phone you are currently using, it can be a latest flagship or a mid-range device, but you can still customize your phone like a pro. You get a dedicated theme store where you can apply different themes, customize all your app icons, you can download different clock styles for your lock screen as well as the always-on display, and the best part is you can install a third-party launcher directly from the Play Store. Apart from this, there is also this exclusive Samsung app called GoodLock, where you can download different modules to customize each and every element on your Samsung device. I even customized my recent apps menu from looking like this to this. There are tons of cool customization features that you get inside GoodLock, and it is absolutely free to install on any Galaxy smartphone. Recently, Apple also added some really cool features in iOS 17, but trust me, they are not even close to Samsung when it comes to customization. If you are using the S23 Ultra, then you also get the S Pen built-in, which not only allows you to take notes, but you can also use it as a remote to click pictures. And when you are in the gallery, you can navigate and browse all the photos one by one. It even lets you to unlock your phone using the S Pen. You can take precise screenshots, and there are so many cool things that you can actually do with the S Pen. You know what the best part is? You don't have to separately purchase this S Pen. It comes built-in right inside your Galaxy S23 Ultra. Now, even after spending so much of money on this expensive iPhone, you don't get any exclusive feature like this. I really appreciate Apple for bringing the Type-C, but if you talk about charging speeds, this is another way that the S23 Ultra beats the iPhone 15 Pro Max. Because the iPhones have a peak wattage of 25 watts compared to the 45 watts on the S23 Ultra. I know it's not the fastest, and there are phones that can go all the way up to 150 watts fast charging. But for now, 45 watts is still much faster than what you get on the 15 Pro Max. On top of that, the Galaxy phone can reverse wirelessly charge other devices. If I just go into settings and then to battery, there is an option called wireless power sharing. Once you turn this on, it basically allows you to charge all your other devices. Let's say I want to quickly charge my AirPods Pro. I just need to place it on the back of my phone and it starts charging. This is a really cool feature, and it can be extremely useful when you are out and you quickly want to charge your smartwatch or even your AirPods. Unfortunately, this feature is still missing on the 15 Pro Max. Next, we have another feature that can be found only in Galaxy devices, and that is the Samsung Dex. Just imagine turning your Android phone into a desktop experience by simply connecting a USB cable from your phone over to a monitor. With Samsung Dex, you can enjoy a desktop-like experience that takes multitasking to the next level. The Samsung Dex experience is something you wouldn't find on any other devices, and I don't think Apple will bring this anytime soon to their iPhones. The next thing I want to talk about is gestures. I really like all the gestures that you get on Samsung devices, and there are so many gestures you can assign for different actions. For example, if I double tap on the screen, it locks my phone. If I want to take a screenshot, I can just swipe with my palm like this. If I swipe with my two fingers from the bottom, it opens up the split screen window. I can even mute my phone using the gesture, so whenever I get a call, I just need to keep my phone face down. And you can assign even more gestures by using an app called One Hand Operations. So gestures are quite useful on Samsung devices, and we don't have many on iOS. So that's pretty much it for this video. These are the 10 reasons why the S23 Ultra is still superior than the 15 Pro Max. If you guys like this video, then be sure to hit that like button. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. I'm Mr. Android, and I'll see you guys in the next one.